Hi, welcome to How to Repair. I'm actually out in the Algarve in Portugal at the moment on holiday, and within a few hours of getting off the plane, a friend contacted me with regards to his solar water heating system, and he's basically told me that the emergency electrical system, which is hidden behind this plate here, is not heating the water. He's not getting enough hot water to run the house. Now, although the two panel system with a 300 litre tank is more than adequate 90% of the year, but when we have these long periods of overcast rainy weather, it doesn't generate enough heat to create 300 litres of hot water for the house, and this is why you have an emergency system built into it. It is really only there for a couple of months in the year during the winter when we have these long periods of no sunshine, and although it's overcast today, I can actually feel there's quite a bit of heat coming off the panels, but of course it's not enough to heat 300 litres of water. So we're suspecting that we have a fault with the emergency electrical system, and I'm going to show you how to test this and also replace this. And while I'm doing this, we'll be inspecting the anode for any wear on the anode, because the anode is there to stop electrolysis taking place, and this needs replacing every 3 to 5 years anyway, and this unit has not been touched for about 10 years, so it's way overdue some service and maintenance. But let's get on with the job. Okay, hidden behind this panel is the electrical system, and I'm quickly going to undo the screws around it to remove it. And the screws are quite loose, so I'll replace these after with slightly wider ones, and the panel comes away. Okay, we've got the cover off, and as you can see, we have the earthing wire, we have a neutral wire, and we have a live wire. The first thing you really want to be testing, because in a lot of villas, sometimes something may have blown a trip or something on the house, is to check that you have electricity going to the actual heater unit. So I'm setting my multimeter on AC voltage, and I will just rest that there for you. And I will do a test across the two wires going to the thermostat here, and as you can see, we've got 240 volts, which is fine. I can also see that we have a thermostatic adjustment here for the temperature, and if you listen closely, you can hear the thermostat adjusting. This means that the points are clicking in and clicking out, which it should happen, but we're still getting no heat. Now, I'm lucky, I've got an expensive meter here, or not expensive one, but a good meter, and I've got AC ampage, and I can stick that onto the live wire, and when the thermostat clicks in, I should be seeing somewhere in the region of anything between 1500 watt to 2500 watt, maybe even 3 kilowatt being drawn. Depends on the size of the heating element that's actually installed, but there is no power being drawn. So either we have a faulty thermostat or a faulty heater, but until I get this unit out, I'm unable to do a continuity test on the element. So we need to strip this down. So the first thing I need to do is drain the tank down and turn the electricity off to the actual unit. Okay, I've actually disconnected the power from the house completely, and as you can see, I've now taped up the ends just for safety, and I've disconnected the electrical unit. I've turned the power back on now, so we can actually do some maintenance on this tank. Now, the thermostat is mounted on this one on top of the heating element, so I imagine that this is the spade connector type, and we just need to pull this off. Yeah, and as you can see, this has got two spade connectors that go into the element. So the first thing we need to do is do a continuity test on the element, and just setting my meter up to ohms, the element has got 2000 watts stamped on it at 220 volts, and I'll try and set the meter up so you can see. So going across these two terminals, we should have a ohms reading, and we do. and it's 24.7, 24.8 ohms reading. This would equate to just over a 2000 watt element. Don't forget my meter is not calibrated, and also the element is 10 years old, so there will be a difference between what the manufacturer stamps on the plate to the ohms reading. Now you can use Ohm's Law calculator to check this, and it will be on the website. So we know the element is good, so therefore the thermostat must be at fault. And if I just put this here for you, okay, as you can see, we've got neutral stamped on this side, live on this side, and I'm setting the let me just put this in so I can get a good reading. The thermostat clicks there, so I'm quickly going to test across for live and the two terminals, and I've got no reading on continuity, no reading on continuity. I'm going to move the thermostat so it clicks. I've still got no continuity on that terminal and no continuity on that terminal. I'll just check the neutral. Nothing on that one. Nothing on that one. Move the thermostat back so it clicks the other way. Just do a test on that. And no continuity at all. This means that the thermostat has either been damaged due to a power surge, possibly. In countries like Portugal, Spain, Greece, they do occasionally get power spikes on the national grid, and sometimes that these can damage the actual thermostatic systems. Basically, inside you have got a set of points, and these points open and shut at the required temperature. So when it gets to 60 degrees, the points open. When it cools down to 35 degrees or 40 degrees, the points shut, allow the heating element to come on. It's a straightforward thermostatic system, and sometimes when they get power surges and everything else, the points can get damaged. Either they carbonize, meaning electricity can't pass through the two contacts, or they actually burn the contacts out completely. So we need to replace the thermostatic system, but I'm not going to do it on this one. I'm going to replace the whole unit. Now the whole unit, the standard type units are, you have an element, you have an anode that screws onto here, which I will bring up in a minute, and you've also got the thermostat. Now these are universal thermostats, and as you can see, they've got a different wiring configuration. This element is a 2 kilowatt one, and we'll just drop that on, and basically you have two screws that will do up the terminals there, and then you collect the live and neutral to the other side, and it's exactly the same system. The plates are the same, and we'll put a new gasket in as well, but the main reason I'm replacing all of this is it's a 10-year-old system. The anode needs replacing, and I want to give the inside of a tank a clean, because I think you'll be very surprised what comes out of this tank, because it has not been touched for 10 years. So we'll get on with a drain down now. Now to drain the system down, we need to turn off the cold water supply going to the tank. I won't be filming this because it's just basically straightforward. So turn the cold water supply off to the tank, then you will need to open the hot water system and drain the system down. When we undo these bolts here, we will get some water coming out of here as the vacuum dissipates. The vacuum basically is when I open the cold water tap downstairs, with the cold water going to the tank off, what actually happens, it creates a vacuum in the tank, and we need to crack this vacuum for the tank to drain down properly. But you will get a little bit of mess, but I'll show you how to do this in a second. And that is not budging, so it's most probably calcified up inside so badly. So I'm going to undo all these small nuts on the plate and see if we can release the vacuum that way. And these are much looser. Just loosen them off. You don't want the plate to come off, because you've still got a lot of water. It's very lucky that we're doing this on such an overcast day. If it was a sunny day, you would have to put a blanket all over the actual panels so you don't actually create too much heat. Now all those are loose. Okay, as you can hear, I've managed to get this piece of bar in just to crack the seal, and it's now draining down, and we've got a little bit of water going in. Okay, we've drained down the system now completely. The tank's still got a bit of water in. There was a lot of water that came out of this, so let's just take this heater out, and you can see the calcium that's falling off it already. And oh god, it is a chocker. That is why you replace the anodes and have calcification systems. The whole tank is chocker with calcium. The anode has completely dissipated. There's nothing left of it. I'm so glad I've taken the heater out. I can see corrosion on the heater as well, and that needs totally replacing. Okay, before I start reassembling the new one, as I was showing you, this is the heater and what is left of the anode. After cleaning out the tank, I found the old anode. And if you look at that, while I put this down a second, and I show you the new heater system, you can see here that the new anode, this is what stops basically electrolysis taking place and destroying your tank system. Now, because it's close to Christmas, this tank has got a lot of corrosion inside, a lot of damage inside the tank that I was seeing. It will need replacing in a couple of years. This tank is 12 years old, we've worked out, and it would have gone on for about 20 years if it had been kept in good condition. But because the anode was so corroded and had not been maintained, this is why I think the tank system now will only last a couple of years. But at least this gets them out of the way for Christmas and able to have hot water throughout the house. I also wanted to show you what this is, the second bucket. And if you look at this, yeah, this is what came out of the tank. Calcium, there's all sorts of crud that is in there. At the end of the day, this system needs to be maintained. All electronic mechanical items do need servicing, and this is why you should always maintain your solar water systems. And the three things that are very important that you do: every 3 years minimum, check the anode. Every 5-6 years, it is worth replacing the heating system, because they do wear. It's the same as your cooker element or tumble dryer element or washing machine element. They do need servicing and maintenance. And the third thing is, don't just think that's it. Every 5 years or so, replace the glycol that runs through the solar water system. This is basically, if I explain the system to you, you have a radiator, and I'm taking this into layman's terms so you understand. Basically, inside there is a heat exchanger. It's like a car radiator. And the heat that comes off the panels basically rises, because heat rises, it goes into the radiator system or the heat exchanger, exchanges the value, calorific value, to the water in the tank. And as this liquid cools, it comes back down onto the front of the panels. Then the heat rises over the panels and then goes into the tank, and the whole system does it again. It is very important that you do maintain your systems, and it's literally 3-4 hour job every 5 years. It's not a lot to ask. But anyway, let's install the new system. I've put the seal on, And as you can see, we've got the anode and the element, and I've attached it to a universal thermostat which operates between 30 degrees and 80 degrees. And we'll just connect the wires up on the live and the neutral either side, and then the thermostat sends the electricity through to the element. So let me just show you how this goes on. So we're just got the gasket on, as you can see all the bolts there, and I'm putting the anode on the side and the heating element on the side so they don't interfere with each other. And I'll just carefully get this lined up on the studs, drop that in, and now we can put the bolts on. Okay, the afternoon wind has picked up now. I've got the tank filling, turned the water supply on. I've connected the live to one side, neutral to the other side. This goes through the thermostat to the two inner terminals, which is the heating element. And then the earth is actually bonded to the chassis on one of the bolts. This now is filling. And what I suggest you do is literally just, the electric's off, so I don't need to worry. Just go round as it fills up and just give it quarter of a turn on each one. Once they're all tight, let the tank fill completely. Turn on the hot taps in the house to get rid of any air bubbles out of the system. Make sure that the tank is filling, emptying through the hot water supply, then turn the heating system on. Now, as you can see, I've set the thermostat up to 50 degrees, which is ample for this house. Okay, we've got the multimeter here now, and we'll just do some last tests on this. I've already know that it's heating the water because this house has got 10 kilowatts of solar electricity, and as soon as I turned the water system on and the electrical system on, I could see 2 kilowatt being drawn. But if I do an AC test across the feed into the thermostat, I've got 237 volts, and then you've got the two wires that come out from the thermostat to the heating element, and if I test across there, I also have 237 volts. This means that the power is going to the element where the old element was faulty. Now, if I turn my clamp-on meter to AC ampage and just zero it down, and I put that on the live wire, we're pulling just over 8 amps, which means that this element is a 2 kilowatt element, and using Ohm's law, which I've put in the description on this video, the calculator, you're able to put the amperage in, or the wattage of the element, and it will tell you the amperage that needs to be drawn or should be being drawn, and it will also show you what the Ohm's resistance should be of the element when you're testing it, as I did earlier in the video. So I can bolt all this together now. The water should be up to temperature within an hour, hour and a half, and the people here will be able to have a shower. So thanks very much indeed for watching the video. Do remember, at the website, not only do we have tutorials on domestic appliance repairs and installations, we also do solar and also solar water systems. So you've got a lot of videos there to assist you in all your household repairs. Thank you very much indeed for watching, and there's a link in the description to the page that will show you where to get all these elements, thermostats and anodes, and how to size them as well. Thanks very much indeed for watching.